And joining me now, our editorial director, Chuck Stokes. Thank you for joining us. Let's talk about that record, that asterisk right there. There's the Dean of Congress, founding member of Congressional Black Caucus. He was on President Nixon's enemies list.
That's two.
A lot to go over in the 53 years. What are some of his biggest accomplishments?
Oh, without a doubt. And you heard some of it in the piece that we just saw. He was at the forefront of almost all of the major civil rights acts, whether it was the 1965 Voting Rights Act. There were just so many things that he touched. And then when he became chairman of the House Judiciary Committee, the first African American to have that position, that was great pride. And it wasn't just pride for Detroit. It was pride for African Americans across this country. John Conyers had a national stature because of the positions that he held and because of his longevity. He was second only to John Dingell. It was ironic that both of them were right here from our neck of the woods in Michigan. And then when John Dingell retired, then he moved up and he became what they call affectionately the dean. But he was also called a cardinal. When you have a position, you're chairing a major committee like that, they affectionately call you a cardinal. But people perhaps forgot some of the little things that he did that were very important. Besides, when Rosa Parks couldn't get a job because of the Montgomery bus boycott, he had her come work in his office, and she worked there for many, many years. Those are the things that he reached out to do. Of course, the Martin Luther King birthday. He introduced it. He fought year after year after year until he wore the Congress down, basically, and then he got it through until the country came around and realized that's a national holiday we should have.
And quickly, you were telling me about his outside of politics personality a little bit. Tell us about that.
You know, he loved tennis. He played well into his senior years. He was physically fit. You never saw him, you know, not in shape. He was that type of guy. And he loved jazz. He was a jazz aficionado. And he could talk to you about the major policy issues. And then with just a quick pivot, he'd start talking to you about Ella Fitzgerald and John Coltrane and Dizzy Gillespie. And these were people that he didn't just go see. He knew, and when those people came to Washington, they would stop in and they'd want to see John Conyers because of his love for jazz and the relationships. And he fought also, policy-wise, to make sure that entertainers got the royalties that they deserved. So he was a very versatile, he was a Renaissance man. And of course, his very dapper dresser. Everybody always talked about the fact that he had the best ties in Washington.
And his impact was felt across the district and beyond.
No question about it. He will not be forgotten, a real champion and a great legacy.
All right. Thank you. Chuck Stokes.